that, you know, I really wanted to write a book, but I never have actually. And I started going with, what do I want to write? And I started writing all kinds of different stories. And I was writing a lot of stuff. There's a lot of work in progress stories sitting in my inbox, in my work folder. And there are about, I think, 6 or 7 of them currently work in progress. And yet, I mean, I noticed that they were not really motivating me enough to cause some sort of a, what can I say, a conclusion or a closure. I was just wanting to, you know, always having this writer's block, and I would get up to write and I would not be able to proceed further. I was visiting my parents' home, and suddenly in a conversation with my father, who is an Indian Naval officer and an award winner, and he's a fantastic human being and someone who I love the most in this world. So I started talking to him, and, you know, all we'd heard his stories of the war and his childhood and his life so many times. And I never really, like, you know, paid too much attention to, you know, what all could perhaps be that maybe I'm not asking. Around the same time, I also became a leadership coach and a life coach. And in this process, while being a coach, I started also realizing that how you ask questions matters a lot. So what is it that I can ask a person that makes the person start wanting to share better with me, right? And I started asking my father certain questions about his life story. And while he was talking to me about the, you know, his life, I realized that there were so many aspects of his life I had no idea about, because I'd never really asked. And because he was always telling it to us, it became like a repeat record in our heads. And we never really bothered to know more, you know? And suddenly there was so much revelation, because when you ask questions, open-ended questions about something that's happened, so much more comes out. So my book is a literary fiction novel based on true events. It's a story of a warrior. It's a story of a real life hero who is my father. And I wanted to start the story, you know, with the intention of doing it with, you know, this is my dad and I want to write the story. But as I started writing the story, I realized that, as usual, my way of, you know, adding things started into it. And it started becoming fictional in that sense. And therefore, there was a lot of fiction, you know, tied into the book as well, apart from the real story that there is. So what is it that inspired me to write? I guess his life story. He's an amazing man. Just to give you a perspective, he is the first Indian naval officer to attack enemy territory during the 1971 war, and also sink an enemy ship, which is called PNS Khyber. When you think about it, it's a very dangerous act, and it's a very scary act. And it's also very brave, because when you go out into war, you don't know what's going to happen, whether you're going to come back or not. And you do, when you go into war, your families never really know you're going into war, because all of this is very discreet and secretive and everything is done under wraps. And I always asked my dad, I said, why did you, you know, when you did that, when you shot the, you know, the missile button, because he was the captain of the ship, didn't you feel that, you know, scared or something? So he says, no, I didn't feel scared. I knew I had to do this because I was representing my ship, my 30 men, my Navy, my country. If I didn't do it, they would. They were coming for me. They would have killed me and all my people, and a huge war would have waged the way war had started. So I said, but how did you have the clarity at that moment to press the button and not feel fear at all? He says, because in that moment, that is the only thing I was looking at. In that moment, that's the only thing I needed to do. That was my duty. And I said to him, you know, I said, it's interesting that you say this, because 5-6 years before that, in 1964, there was a cyclone where my father was a captain of a small, you know, sort of patrol boat called INS Sharda. And at INS Sharda, he was caught in a cyclone in 1964, December. And during that time, his was the only boat that was available again from the Indian Navy to save over 3,000 people. So on the one hand, here is a man who comes from very humble beginnings, from the time of partition, where his entire family wealth was left behind, where they were living in Pakistan, now Pakistan. In those days, it was India. And they came to Phagwara, which is Punjab here in India, to start a life of absolute penury, to start a life with nothing, and to begin life and join the Indian Navy as a sailor with no backing, with nothing. And when you join as a sailor, with no anticipation of what life could perhaps be like from there on, he still went on and on and on and began to do better and better. And within a few years, he became an officer and rose the ranks. So here was a man who started from nothing, who dedicated himself, worked hard, put all his effort, and he became not only a war hero, but he also became a safe time hero. And he won the President's Award on two occasions, the Ati Vishish Seva Medal and the Veer Chakra. So he is a hero. And what is it that makes him a hero in every moment of his life is that when he is where he is, in the here and now, he is completely present. He is always present. He doesn't carry baggage. He doesn't carry historical, you know, this, that, and the other. He doesn't worry. This needs to be done. All right, I have all my energies going into it now. And that became inspiration for me. That such a person to be able to develop, you know, a sense of presence and focus, such clarity in the moment, and bringing his entire energy towards this, this story has to be shared. And I put, you know, my fingers to keyboard, and I started writing the story. Of course, there were writer's block in this as well. There were times I just couldn't proceed. There came a point that I just was not able to tie all the, so much of information was there. There was his piece of information, my imagination, extra pieces that we included to make the whole book, you know, an interesting read. So much of dialogue. None of the dialogue, of course, he told me I had to recreate it. So there were a lot of challenges, but to be able to do it all. In fact, it took me 5 years to complete the whole journey. And there were many times that I came to a point that I'm not so sure I can do this. I'll have to quit. I don't think I can complete. And I came very close to quitting. But somehow, something or the other made the way. And I was able to complete this. We finally launched the book on the 9th of October last year. And it was the most beautiful ceremony. Both my parents were there, surrounded by Indian Naval, you know, officers and many family people, other people from the Navy, some people from the media. And it was the most beautiful event. So during the pandemic, in all the madness, we had a virtual launch. And it was the most special moment of my life. Aditi, I hope that answers your question.
Not very clearly. I would like to know that, as you said, that you weren't a born writer. You had various, hurdles in the way that you many a times you thought of going back. So while writing a book or while writing an article or anything, what all things should be kept in mind to keep it, straightforward to the point? Because we get many thoughts while writing on a certain topic. So what all things can we keep in mind to write that thing so that it is perfectly in the frame of what we want to write and it doesn't include any extra things?
Nice. Good question, Aditi. And it's a very pertinent question for any author, actually. I think the main key thing that why you want to write is, what's the key message you want to bring across? What's the key identity, the key piece of information that you want to definitely share is what's very important for me to put down. And I did put that down. But like they say, you know, you've got to have structure to the imagination also. Imagination is wild. You can go crazy writing, right? You can write anything about the stars and the moons and the sky. But all of that needs to connect finally to the protagonist. So who is the protagonist? What is his or her story? Why is the story needing to be? Why is it important for the world to know this story? What about that story is beautiful, right? What are the key elements of that story you want to put down? So the fact of actually chronicling every aspect of it was very important. So therefore, putting down, so what I did do first was this, so there were various stages. I did an audio recording of my dad's story where he talked about it. Then I myself transcribed it. Then I started doing an audio recording of myself as what my understanding of the story is. Then I transcribed that. And then I also put in things about, you know, what example, for example, when I'm wanting to write the whole story, you know, which elements, which are the key chapters I want to put down. So I started putting down a listing of the chapters. Then what could go into that chapter? Which are the side characters we want to build around them? How do you build the character curve? And, you know, how do you, what aspects of the character do you want to show? How does that character tie in with the protagonist? So there are many elements that you need to keep in mind while you're writing a story. And what I best suggest for, you know, most, you know, people who are wanting to or contemplating, and I think everyone should write a book, because the reason I'm saying this and I'm saying people who want to write is everyone should try to write, because everyone's life is a unique story in itself, right? So put down and write, because you never know what might come out of it and what might, a learning might come out of it from to somebody else in somebody else's life, because every life is relatable, right? So put things down and decide, all right, in my story, in my key story, in my personal life, for example, I would have met thousands and thousands of people by now, because I teach constantly at a lot of colleges and things like that. So many students, so many types of people, et cetera, et cetera. So keeping in mind that when you say, out of all those thousands, which are the key and the most important people that have impacted my life story? That means that have had an effect on my life. And because of which those people need to be stitched into the story and build their character curve along with my protagonist's character curve as well. Yeah. So this is very important to understand what exactly is the message I want to give, who all is giving it, who all is aiding that message, and building each of their stories along with the main character's story. So that, and finally tying it all in. Right. Aditi, does that answer your question?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much. I'd like to ask the audience and the participants, if they have any question, they can ask ma'am. They can type it in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and ask the question.
Good afternoon, ma'am. It's really an honor to see you and have a talk with you.
Thanks, Fatima. Tell me.
So, ma'am, basically, I believe that if anyone wants to, if anyone who feels he or she is not creative should really read fiction books so that they can bring a creative self, you know, their creative self out. So, can you help or advise some small bloggers like us of how to bring our creative fictional self out? By the time we are just, you know, we are all surrounded by only self-help books and all, like people are promoting self-help books so much that the fictional stories are, you know.
Right. So I really feel, Fatima, what you can perhaps do is, like you very rightly said, read a lot, because when you read, you understand how expression is done and you understand how a plot unfolds, or you understand what the flow of a particular subject could look like and it could change to be, you know, whether you want to talk some element of the climax in the beginning, do you want to break up the story? Do you want to, you know, how do you want to bring each character in? So there are different styles. All kinds of authors have tried so many different things, and you should read, as reading is really helps. In addition, reading different types of books as well. So some of the, there's so many books out there in the market. You know, pick up any, you know, bestseller, start reading any particular author that, you know, you get comfortable with. Each person has their own, I'd say, you know, level of, you know, understanding, liking, and, you know, story liking, etc. I really, you know, as a kid, I mean, when I was a little girl, I used to read a lot of Enid Blyton. I read a lot of Nancy Drew and a lot of Hardy Boys and, you know, St. Clair's and all of those typical Enid Blyton books. And that's what my storytelling, you know, all this like whole excitement that would happen, the drama and the whole element of all that started there. I don't know what your interests of reading is today, but there is of course the Harry Potter series. There's a gentleman called I can't remember his name. His name is Mr. Tripathi. But his Shiva trilogy. Try and read that that whole series. That's an excellent set. Then there's Ricordian that's there. I could send a Commander a set of book sets that I think that y'all could read. My memory is failing me right now, but I will send you a list of books that I could recommend that you guys read. And reading really helps open the mind. It improves your vocabulary. It helps you showcase how expression can be done, how a story can be told, how to build a character, how characters tie in, how suddenly surprises build, how a climax is taken all the way up, and how to keep the person engaged, you know, from one chapter to the next, to the next, to the next. So there's different techniques. And if you really want to, you know, there are different courses that you can do as well to write, to learn how to write a book. Courses can help you literally, you know, practice different types of emotion, bring out certain emotions about certain your own life and put it into a narrative way. And that helps you then build certain, you know, ways of telling the story. So if you have it in your mind that, you know, you want to write, Fatima, just begin. Just begin. Open a laptop, or if you don't have a laptop or a computer or, you know, even a book, just start writing the story. Who do you want to write about? What about that story excites you? Why do you want to tell it? So begin.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
You're welcome.
I hope anyone else does not have any question. If you all do have a question, then please put it in the chat box. We'll wait for 1 or 2 minutes. Then we'll move ahead.
I can be here for a few more minutes. I think you should start the rest of the
Okay, ma'am. Sure.
And if anybody has, I can respond later. Yeah.
Sure, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Well. Next up, we have Mr. Hiro Keshwani, sir. He's an alumni of FTII Pune. He's a renowned director of photography, having worked on features, ads, and TV serials. Hiro Keshwani, sir, has recently shot for a feature production titled Torbaz, directed by Girish Malik, starring Sanjay Dutt, to be released on Netflix soon. He has also been working with directors like Vinod Chopra, Raju Hirani, PLA Films, Sanjeev Shah, and Milind Ranade, to name a few, and also has a vast experience in digitally restoration of films. Sir, I request you to please take over from here.
Thank you so much for this introduction. I kind of feel embarrassed by all this. I've always been behind the camera, away from the limelight and all. I put lights on people rather than having a light on me. So thank you so much. And thank you, AOL. And thank you, everybody on the panel, Priya ji and Magre saab, to join you in this inauguration of this literary club. What to say? For me, from my filmmaking point of view, our sacrosanct Bible is the script. Everybody goes by the script. The kind of the director writes whatever his thought, story, idea, line of thought is. He puts it on paper, then puts it as a screenplay. Then that is taken up as a cue for us, like a cinematographer, to figure out what is the flow of the story, what are the highlight points, and what are the moods being invoked. And we, along with whatever is being conveyed in terms of visuals, in terms of the setting, the atmosphere, the setting, the location, and the dialogues, we try to enhance it further with lighting, in terms of whether it's a bright bubbly scene or it's a thriller, is it a murder mystery, is it a comedy, is it a human drama. So for us, it is all there in the script. I tell my students also while teaching them that you have to learn to read the script. There are just words on it, but those words are pushing you into doing something, evoking something. See, whether we read a novel, a poem, or any article, the first thing which goes into our mind is the edit pattern of what is unfolding. If you are reading a fiction, the story starts while you are reading the pages and the words, the story starts working in your mind as in terms of visuals, in terms of frames. You look into it carefully, you'll start seeing these patterns. Aapka ek visual creation shuru ho jata hai mind mein. So words are powerful. And what I would like to say is, with this literary club, maybe people are joining just for the sake of reading or just for the sake of entertainment, or also to enhance themselves further as a profession, as writing as a profession, whether it's a book, a novel, an article, journalism, it can be anything. I think my request would be, as Priyaji also suggested, read a lot. Read in your own comfortable language. That is a must. See what is happening around you. That is also a must, because suppose you are 16 today, you may not have the insight into how a life is, but you may get prompted to write something about an elderly person. You have not experienced it, but be observant to how things are, how your grandfather is living, how other elderly people in your neighborhood or surroundings are living. Unless and until you have a compassion and an empathy towards others, you won't be able to bring in. Otherwise, you'll have to wait till you're 60 or 70 years of age, and then only you'll be able to write those experiences. So you have to be observant. You have to know what being that kind of a person or in that situation, what it means. And that is having a very sharp imagination. You have to have your imagination intact and on an overdrive most of the times, because then things will be very easy to put your thoughts on paper. I can go on and on about these things, but if there is anything specific, any specific questions, I'll be ready to answer that.
So how reading has helped you to develop this imagination or looking behind and understanding, being empathetic and being able to create it to a level that people connect with the content that you are portraying?
I'll have to live my life all over again to answer that. But as Priyaji also said, it doesn't come easily. It's a process. It's a process from your childhood to your teenage years to your school, college life. It's like the kind of reading and the kind of books you take up as your reading material, and the age group, the era you are in. So all that is a cumulative thing, and it's all happening in the background. There is no rule written ki agar ek kitab likhni hai to aise likhni hai, ek film ka screenplay ya story likhni hai to aise likhni hai. There will be many help books available for screenplay writing and script writing. There will be books by Sid Field and many other authors, and you will be clamoring and running to a bookshop to buy ऑल द 5-6 बुक्स और मे बी मोर कि मैं पढ़ लूं, मैं सीख लूं कि इसको लिखते कैसे हैं। यहां से आता है लिखना। जब तक यहां से इमोशंस नहीं आएंगे, यहां से थॉट प्रोसेस नहीं आएगा, ये जो मोटर रिएक्शन है फ्रॉम ब्रेन टू द हैंड, इट इज वेरी नेसेसरी। यू नो, आई वॉज इन दिल्ली रिसेंटली एंड आई हैपन टू मीट, आई कैन कॉल हर माई नीस, एंड शी टोल्ड मी दैट हर इंटरव्यू हैड कम इन द हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स, वेयर हाउ द चिल्ड्रन आर रिएक्टिंग एंड टीनेजर्स आर रिएक्टिंग टू दिस पैंडमिक एंड द लॉकडाउन। And she said the one most important thing I shared was, we have forgotten to write. We are always on, we are on our cell phones typing. We are not writing. So this thought, the words which are exploding here, the emotions which is exploding here, the way it has to get converted through your pen onto those words on the paper, that connect is very important. It's the same way you actually physically read a book. It's very different to read a e-paper or a PDF version of that book. It's maybe the same feeling. So I don't know. I may be veering away from your question, but I hope I was somewhere close to answering your question.
Thank you, sir.
So I would also like to ask.
Yeah.
So, sir, basically, when we write short stories or anything for that matter, if we write anything, there is a constant fear of getting judged. Like, is it like the best thing I can put it out there? Like, what they will think? Or I should work on it more and it will get better the next day when I'll work on it again. So there is a constant fear of judgment which stops us to like publishing our work to someone or somewhere. So how we decide that, okay, this is the point where I'm done working on this article and this is the point where this article needs to get out somewhere in the world.
Again, like I said earlier, it has to come from the heart. So your mind and your heart will say, yeah, this is right. First, you have to outpour whatever you are trying to say and trying to convey. If you yourself are not convinced, you will keep on writing pages and pages. You won't get your satisfaction ever. It's when you draw a line and say, yeah, even I would cry on reading this, or I would laugh on reading this. You are your own barometer, because you in yourself are so unique that you are very different from others. You have that uniqueness in you which makes you you. Don't confuse it with that me is me. Not that one. But so only when you are convinced that, yeah, I have achieved, this is what I wanted to put on paper or convey my thoughts. If you are convinced, then go out. Don't bother whether your grammar is right or wrong, your punctuation, stop marks are right or wrong. Just figure out whether those emotions are coming out or not. There are people who will help you with these kind of things, with the grammar, the punctuations. Editors are there for that. They'll figure out. First, it has to come from you because you are writing it. It's your unique point of view. Everybody is special in their own way. I tell my camera students, okay, if I ask you to shoot a simple shot, like take a shot of a lock on the door, a key lock on the door. So show me what you can do. I will be looking for anybody who tries to shoot that lock in a very different, unique angle, because that is what will make his point of view different. Otherwise, ek simple sa tarike se सामने कैमरा रख के वी कैन ऑलवेज शूट इट, जैसे सब लोग करते हैं। क्या आपको सब लोग बनना है कि आपको अपना वजूद खड़ा करना है?
Thank you so much, sir, for your advice. I hope if anyone has any questions, they can ask, or else we'll wait till the end. Okay, thank you so much, sir. Next up, we have Mr. Girish Magre. He's a founder of BMC Electricals. He is known as someone who lived life on his own terms. Mr. Girish, sir, had a penchant for poetry, which flows unabatedly through his first book, Tasveer Ek Sukhan. Taking this passage and relating it to entrepreneurship, it takes hard work to reach that life-changing moment and think about society and welfare of being as in humanitarian by founding Sanapi. In the modern business world, it's about what you can do and not how you look like, he believes. Sir, I request you to please take over from here.
Your mic is off.
So please unmute. So
you're still on mute.
I think there's a problem. What you need to
sir,
do...
Sir, I think your mic volume will be maybe low. If you can increase your mic volume.
Hello. Yeah, I'm Purva here. Fatima, Girish sir is trying to connect. I think he is having some issue with his mic. Some setting problem is there. I just called him. Yeah.
So can he connect through mobile? If you could share.
Yes. He is trying to do that.
Hello.
Yeah.
Now we can hear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Sorry.
So one second, sir. You have to leave that other meeting.
Sir, you are connected on two devices, na? So the other meeting, you just close it, it's echoing.
I disconnected the PC.
Yes, sir. Now it's better.
Hello, everybody.
Yes, sir. Now it's better.
You can hear me, no?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. We can
hear you. Actually, in Aurangabad today, there is a industrial power staggering off, and we are running on inverter, so the batteries. And as usual, the Marathwada, this region of the state, gets secondary treatment all the time. So please excuse me for this. There is a problem in the signal and also in the electricity connection. I am working on inverter right now. So is it audible now?
Yes, sir. It is very
clear. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. I'll try to connect myself as best as possible on video audio. So Commander VP Singh, Priya Sharmaji, and Hiru Keswani ji, thank you so much for accommodating me, a professional electrical engineer, in the forum of literarial gathering. And thank you so much, the young writers, budding writers from this college, to listen to me. I would like to tell you something about my journey in literature, and you may perhaps pick up some glimpses out of it and use it for your own writing skills, and maybe answer your possible questions in this forum. I am actually an electrical engineer, and I was working in Crompton Hughes, and prior to that in Westinghouse in USA. And for last 15 years, I am on my own, started this electrical industry, which looks little odd for a literarial arena. But I was very much impressed by a theme your group has selected. To write better, you have to read better. So this is what I think perhaps I was been doing so for last around 30, 35 years, 40 years. And this has tempted me to get into a kind of amateur writing. I'm not a very professional writer. It so happened, I can also speak in Hindi and Urdu in between, because some of my work is in Urdu. Main belong karta hu Maharashtra ke is region se jo Marathwada hai, aur ye Marathwada till 1949 tak it was under Nizam state. And incidentally, my father is a postgraduate in Urdu from Usmania University. So we had an atmosphere of Urdu speaking people around in our region. And my friends, my colleagues, and few of my close associates, they were speaking a lot of Urdu, mixed Hindi. So this tempted me to write something in Hindi. And five years ago, I am actually an artist also. I do some watercolor paintings. So what I did, I just had an idea of mixing a painting skill and the artwork together with poetry. And maine fir aisa socha ki kyun na koi achhi ghazal ya poetry aur ek kisi artist ka koi picture ek saath usi subject ka jod lete hai, and why not we make a kind of coffee table book out of it. To maine is idea se inspire hoke ek बुक लिखा मैंने, और जिसमें जिसका नाम है तस्वीरें सुखन। तस्वीरें सुखन का मतलब है सुखन इज पोएट्री एंड तस्वीर इज तस्वीर पिक्चर आर्ट। तो पोएट्री की तस्वीर या तस्वीर का तस्वीर की पोएट्री ऐसा भी कह सकते हैं। तो मैंने वर्ल्ड वाइड काफ़ी फेमस आर्टिस्ट के पेंटिंग्स उनसे परमिशन लेके कलेक्ट किए और उस सब्जेक्ट से रिलेटेड कुछ पोएट्री बनाई उर्दू में, और वो मैंने तस्वीरें सुखन नाम से पब्लिश की। तो उसमें वो मैंने दो पार्ट में की लिखी थी। एक तो था कि तस्वीरें सुखन में गज़लें कुछ या नज़्म जो रोमांटिक थी, जो टिपिकली गज़ल आप देख सकते हैं कि रोमांटिक ज़्यादातर रोमांटिक होती है, और लेकिन मैंने थोड़ा हट के एक दूसरा भी उसका पार्ट बनाया पार्ट टू में, जो दुनियादारी की गज़लें या दुनियादारी की नज़में, जिसमें मैंने लेटेस्ट कोई जो इश्यूज है मोलेस्टेशन है या फार्मर की सुसाइड्स है, वाटर इश्यूज है, और मतलब रिस्पेक्ट टुवर्ड्स विमेन, जेंडर इक्वलिटी, फिर कुछ जो स्पिरिचुअल चीज़ें हैं जो आम तौर पे गज़ल में नहीं आती है, सारी रोमांटिक ही ज़्यादा होती है। तो इस सब्जेक्ट पे मैंने ज़्यादा तवज्जो दिया, और मैंने वो तस्वीरें सुखन का पार्ट टू लिखा जो काफ़ी लोगों ने लाइक किया। The book was published 4-5 years ago, and it was published in various countries. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Yeah, because I'm a little doubtful. Somebody has to respond to me in between. I am afraid of getting lost in audio. Aditi, I'm audible. Hello.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So let it be a little interactive in between so that I get a confidence of my audio system. तो मैंने तस्वीरें सुखन पार्ट टू दुनियादारी की नज़में लिखी, और ये मैंने जो बुक लिखी वो हिंदी देवनागरी और उर्दू पारसी राइटिंग में भी लिखी है स्क्रिप्ट में। तो एक ही पेज में एक ही किताब में एक तरफ पन्ने के उर्दू और दूसरी तरफ हिंदी, इस तरह का मैंने फॉर्मेशन रखा था बुक का। और वो पाकिस्तान, बांग्लादेश, तुर्की, सऊदी, जहाँ जहाँ लोग उर्दू पढ़ते हैं, उर्दू समझते हैं, वहाँ पे काफ़ी लोगों ने उसको पढ़ा और टू सम एक्सटेंट अप्रिशिएट भी किया एज अ फर्स्ट ट्रायल ऑफ माय राइटिंग स्किल। उसके बाद में थोड़ी हिम्मत मेरी बढ़ी और मैंने सोचा कि अगर अच्छा पढ़े तो अच्छा लिख भी सकते हैं, और अच्छा लिखने के बाद लोग पढ़ेंगे तो फिर और उत्साह बढ़ता है। तो आई स्टार्टेड राइटिंग इन इंग्लिश एंड आई डिसाइडेड टू राइट अ बुक विच इज रिलेटेड टू माय सब्जेक्ट्स एंड माय profession. I am an electrical engineer and we do a lot of R&D in our factory and a lot of IPR, intellectual property right work. So we file a lot of patents every year. So maine socha ki kyun na students ke liye ya budding engineers ke liye, budding scientists ke liye kuch aise story book likhi jaye ki jisse ho sakta hai wo R&D ke liye इस काम के लिए इंस्पायर हो। सो आई एंड दिस हैड हैपन इन कोविड लॉकडाउन पीरियड, और हमने उसमें आई कलेक्टेड लॉट ऑफ डेटा ऑन वेरियस पीपल एंड डिसाइडेड टू राइट अ बुक ऑन निकोला टेस्ला a famous scientist now, but which was not very famous and known a century ago. Nikola Tesla and five other unsung inventors. ये इस किताब का नाम है और मैंने निकोला टेस्ला के साथ में कुछ और अनसंग इन्वेंटर्स की लाइफ स्टोरीज इसमें लिखी, कुछ इसमें पिक्चर्स या पोर्ट्रेट्स इनके ड्रॉ करके डाले हैं. एंड ये बुक अमेजोन में भी काफ़ी किंडल वर्शन में उसको बेस्ट सेलर का भी प्रमोशन मिला है. और ये बुक अभी तो ज़्यादा इंस्टीट्यूशनल एक्टिविटीज़ बंद होने से एजुकेशन में वी कुड नॉट सर्कुलेट दैट बुक इन इंस्टीट्यूशनल लेवल, बट आई सर्कुलेटेड टू ऑल माय इंजीनियर फ्रेंड्स एंड द पीपल हु आर वर्किंग इन साइंटिफिक एरियाज. एंड दे सेड दे कुड रीड दिस बुक एज अ नॉवल एंड दिस वॉज अ काइंड ऑफ अप्रिशिएशन फॉर माई writing work. And I wanted to make this book more entertaining than a kind of information or technical book. So ye karte samay maine socha ki I actually travel a lot because of my business activity, and I have been traveling since age of 21-22, and I was in US for 1 year in Westinghouse. And incidentally, just let me tell you, Nikola Tesla, a scientist who did a lot of research on AC electrical system, was a consultant to George Westinghouse, the founder of Westinghouse company in USA. And I had an opportunity to sit in the same factory and the same office where Nikola Tesla was sitting. And this was one of the kind of striking point for me to write on Nikola Tesla's life. So I finished these two books in last 4 years. A book in book on Ghazal Nazm Urdu mein, और एक किताब मैंने लिखी है निकोला टेस्ला एंड फाइव अदर्स. एंड देर आर थ्री मोर प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑन गोइंग. आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू नेम इट फॉर यू. एज आई एम ट्रेवलिंग टू वेरियस कंट्रीज, आई यूज टू स्टडी दी फेमस कैरेक्टर्स इन दोज कंट्रीज, बट नॉट वेरी मच नोन टू द अदर पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. तो मैंने फिर ऐसे लोगों की लिस्ट बना के शॉर्ट लिस्ट करके मेरे कुछ ओवरसीज फ्रेंड्स के साथ में डिस्कस करके वो लिस्ट बनाई. एंड आई एम राइटिंग अ बुक कॉल्ड 101 हिडन ज्वेल्स. दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन द पीपल हु आर अलाइव नाउ एंड हु आर नॉट देयर, बट दे हैव डन अ वेरी रिमार्केबल वर्क इन देयर रिस्पेक्टिव कंट्री in special activity and special subject. So this book will be published in August, and as the list was going to be more than 101, because I had already decided a title, 101 Hidden Jewels, so the list became more than 150 on. So I decided to make it in two parts again. And the idea came like, why not I make gender wise 101 hidden jewels for the male and for female, and for a few of the transgender's character I wrote another book, 101 pink samurais. So this was the title I collected for my collection of friends in Japan, and they also like this title, Pink Samurais. So these two books are my two forthcoming projects. And as Hiru sir said, you need not to bother about when you have something in mind and heart, you start expressing vocal or in writing in a scribble form, and need not to worry about the grammar, punctuations and things like that. It will, because what matters most is the essence of the writing. And when it is in a pure and your own form, nothing can beat that. Nothing can beat that. May it be not as superior language like Oxford or maybe very literature language, but the things coming out from your heart and your own creations are very, very appreciated by and large. So these two books are my forthcoming projects, and there is one more book which is because I belong to Aurangabad and this area, and I spent a lot of my career tenure in Aurangabad. I was mesmerized by you might have heard perhaps the name of a person who actually designed the city architecture of Aurangabad, and his name is Malikambar is one of the stalwart fighter in army of Adil Shah, and he was picked up by Aurangzeb because he had a very good architectural mind, and I was very impressed by Malikambar's work, architecture work, and during 17th early 17th century he did a lot of innovative work in civil engineering and architectural field. Like we have water siphoning system of 17th century in Aurangabad, and the water is coming from a lake which is around 20-25 kilometers away from the city, and through a pipeline and a siphoning system it comes to a city center and gets distributed to various localities. A very fantastic water circulation system, and designed by Malikambar, and this is called Nehre Ambari. So I was very much impressed with that, and while doing so I thought, why not we write on another civil engineer who had worked in perhaps a Muslim country and Hindu by religion. And I could find out Sir Gangaram. Sir Gangaram, you might be knowing, there is a hospital in Delhi in the name of Sir Gangaram, and he had done a lot of his architectural work in Lahore, which is now Pakistan. But when he worked there, it was the British India. Sir Gangaram and Malikambar, ये इस किताब का नाम है, और इन्होंने आर्किटेक्चर फील्ड में बहुत बहुत अजूबे काम किए हैं, और ये हिंदी में किताब है. सो द बुक रिटन इन हिंदी एंड उर्दू वॉज माई फर्स्ट बुक तस्वीर सुखन. देन आई स्टार्टेड राइटिंग इन इंग्लिश फॉर the characters and personalities in scientific invention, and now I'm writing the books on various personalities worldwide. It is a very haphazard way of writing, and
Girish,
literarial perhaps Girish? Very high literarial value, but it is my creation, and it is my creation, and I thought that it would be useful to the society, and this has we also incidentally work for we have one small NGO here in Aurangabad called Read and Lead. Read and Lead, and one of my friend Mirza Nadvi means Pandit. He is Pandit in Farsi language, and he's a very good friend of mine, Mirza Nadvi, and we together work on this theme, Read and Lead Foundation, and we go to various Muslim mohallas, gullies, and I try to teach them the local language, Marathi. And under this NGO, we have distributed a lot of Hindu religious books written in Urdu, Mahabharata, mythological literature, Mahabharata, Ramayana, and few other Hindi books. Hindu books are written in Urdu, and we distribute to various Muslim educational institutions. This is one of our agenda this year. And this is how we are connected with the society and promote them. And the most thing I appreciated about this literature group of your college is the theme, to write better, you have to read better. And we do exactly same thing. We promote the society to the youngsters particularly to read better, so that they, some of them can write better. And all my books so far, I try to focus on the aesthetics of the book, so that because nowadays people, young generation is not very much for reading the books in a hard copy form. They like audio books or digital books. And so then I thought, why not we make a very good cover pages, very good formation of the book, so that young people can pick it up. And then, kyunki aapne agar kitab haath mein nahi lenge to aap padhenge kaise? तो किताब हाथ में लेने के लिए बुक स्टॉल से, बुक स्टैंड से, इट शुड बी अट्रैक्टिव इनफ. तो हमने उस पर तवज्जो दी. और एक किसी राइटर का मुझे एक याद है जो उन्होंने कहा था कि किताब इंसान, जब आदमी जब किताब से होके गुजरता है तो आदमी का इंसान बन जाता है. तो आदमी का इंसान बनने के लिए उसको किताबों के थ्रू गुजरना पड़ेगा, और किताबों के थ्रू इसलिए कि किताब आपको कुछ पैसों में, कुछ समय में किसी आदमी का तजुर्बा जो सालों का है, पूरी जिंदगी उसकी है, तो किसी की बायोग्राफी आप पढ़ेंगे 2-3 घंटे में, तो उसकी पूरी जिंदगी आप कुछ पैसों में बुक खरीद के, आई स्ट्रेस मोर ऑन बाइंग द बुक्स. So that we writers can get some money for inspiration and not for earning. So आदमी अगर किताबों से गुजरता है तो वो इंसान बन जाता है. And this is what I like the most out of some people saying on the reading. And this is all about my journey, short journey of literature. Or it will be too louder than seat to call it as a literature, but whatever I scribble and print it, and the books are people are buying it, so that's what I can say. And because I started little late, I have to do it fast. So whatever I had in mind about writing it, maybe few of you can start writing right now, so that you can end up in writing more and more literature and more of more your thoughts on the piece of paper. So I request my young friends that you read better and write better, and start writing now and now onwards, today onwards. And whatever you have in mind, scribble it, try to make it in a longer form, and then show it to some of your friends. If they like it, publish it in whatever form. Good, bad, ugly, don't worry about that. Because everything is as a reference, I mean comparison. So nothing is the best. The best is yet to come. So Aditi, this is all about my travelogue of writing the books. Thank you so much, sir. And I have only one request. In fact, I told Varsha, my friend in your college, Vanganta, Purva, that I have actually a medical emergency, in the sense my father is required to be vaccinated. Today I could not get an appointment this afternoon, but there is an appointment in the evening, and I have to a little early and call it a day so that I can take him to hospital for a second vaccination. Thank you so much, everybody, for listening to me so patiently. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your presence and your time. Thank you.
Commander VP Singh, I have a small request.
Yeah, sir.
If you don't mind, I mean, because I have to, my factory is around 50 kilometers away from city, and I had come to office only for this function. I have to leave now for some, as I told you, a medical emergency. So,
okay, sir. You can leave, no problem.
Leave in the next 5 minutes.
Yes. Okay. You can very well leave now if you have any medical emergency. But yeah, we are very enlightened with the work you have done, and you are an engineer. And after, apart from engineering job, you are doing a lot of other time. You are sparing your time for penning down your stories, your thought process on paper, and your publishing books. It's a commendable job, sir, you are doing.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everybody. And I am available on YouTube for Tasveere Sukhan, and also on Nikola Tesla. So you can follow me on that. And there are some ghazals which are I have done a voice over through a very professional sound artist, and Dr. O.P. Rathore, who is also working for probably Mr. Hiru Keswani, would be knowing him. And he has voice-over some of my ghazals, and wo YouTube par hai available. Kisi ko agar usme interest hai to thoda samay nikal ke tawajjuh de sakte. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, everybody. And I'm extremely sorry for this is not blowing my own trumpet in last 10-15 minutes, but just to tell you that this was my short travelogue of my writing journey, and maybe some of the students can pick up some good things if they feel so from my journey. Thank you so much, and bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Moving on, we have something we have worked really hard on. Our weeks of hard work and efforts are here in front of you. Our very own Sort magazine, Allure. We have Janvi Patil, chief editor of our club, who will be presenting our magazine. Over to you, Janvi.
Yeah, thank you, Aditi. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. So, hello, everyone. I know all of us are very excited for this launch of our magazine. So here we go.
We can't see anything.
Yeah. So first of all, I would like to talk about the name of our magazine. When we first thought about making this magazine, the only thing in our mind was to reach out to those people who have extracurricular talents, like who can write on different topics, or who can paint, or who can share their experiences, which are very important in our life. And we wanted to exert a powerful influence over students through our magazine. And that's where the name Allure comes in. So talking about the content of our magazine, we have vision and mission. Then we have the message from editorial desk. And this is our Allure team 2020. I can see our content writers and editors here who worked very hard for this magazine. and I would like to thank them all for their efforts. Then we have messages from our mentors and our faculty in charges. We have messages from Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, message from Lochan ma'am, message from Commander Vijay Pratap sir, then Rajeshwari ma'am, Mamta ma'am, and Vasudha ma'am. So this is a section of about SOT Club, like what we do in SOT Club or the inauguration of SOT Club, about every bit of information about SOT Club. This is SOT 2019 team, who are also the founders of SOT Club in TCET. And since 2019, we have arranged more than 20 plus events in TCET. So every bit of information is given in this section of events. Like we organize Tata Mumbai Marathon, then webinars on various topics. This is our current team working, that is SOT 2020, and we have messages from SOT 2020-21. Next, we have the achievers, like the winners of various competitions like Talent Hunt and Azade Hunar or Artsy Lens. This is the most awaited section. This is the section of articles. Like as I already said, that we wanted to give platform to those who can write beyond technical things. So this is a section of articles, poems, painting, and journal. For this, we got very nice response from our college. We got various articles, then poems, paintings, and journals, which will influence you. Then talking about this unknown faces of TCET, those faces who has creative talent, but they are not recognized well. So here is the section of their work. Then this section is about social bodies of campus who work very hard for the well of society. Like NSS, Rotarac, EWT. And finally, we have the acknowledgement from Team Alert 2021. You can find this magazine on our website. Thank you. Over to you, Aditi.
Thank you so much, Janvi. The next thing we are going to present is our website. It is like a short handbook, which includes everything about our club. We have Arif Chaudhary, Vice President of SOT, for further presentation and explanation of our website. Over to you, Arif.
Thank you very much, Aditi. Let us proceed with our SOT website launch. So in a very tough times like COVID-19 pandemic, all our club events and activities moves to the digital platform online. So we thought, why not build a website for the club? It will help us in many ways, like registration process will be much simpler. Student can register on the club website easily. We have a better analytics of all the events and even of the age processes. And we can publish all our events there and can provide notification to each of the students of our college. And website can create the transparency between the club and the students of our college. And before that, our most of the college student has no direct access to contact any professional and social bodies of the college to suggest what they would like to do in our college. So also keeping that in mind, we have created a forum in this website, means general discussion. So on our SORT Club website, if they have any suggestion, feedback of our past event and anything, they can contact directly to us and we can interact them directly through this website. So each of these members of our college is registered on this website. All of the events, like upcoming events, past events, about us, we have created a feedback form in the website. They can directly fill the feedback form and can contact us. And each of the activities, each of the categories we have doing in the college, they can go through directly. As for whenever first year students join the college, they don't know much about the particular social bodies or particular professional bodies. So we've created a website so that any first year student can directly come to our website before coming to us. They can see all of the activities that we have done over the past 2 years and over the which categories we have doing the event. If they are interested in that particular activities, so they can join the SORT Club and do the transformation of self-development and show the talent that we have doing, and the social transformation, the most important. And also we have created like the members of the professional body, the student have the direct contact with the members of the body, but not of the club members. So we have created a direct platform for the members of our college to connect with the direct club members of our college to give their personal feedback and idea. Let me give the overview, one look of the website once. I hope this website will help each of the students of our college to connect with us with many more ways, like in the website. So I will be putting a website link on the chat box. They can directly refer to the link of our website. Thank you. Over to you, Aditi.
Thank you so much, Arif. Hello.
Yes,
Aditi. Yeah, Aditi. Okay. So thank you, Arif. Next up, with due respect, I request our Dean, Dr. Lochan Jolly ma'am, to please speak a few words.
Thank you, Aditi. Thank you, everyone. So it gives me a great privilege to speak on this occasion. On behalf of Thakur College of Engineering and Technology, I thank Priya Madam, Hiru Sir, and Girish Sir for taking out time from their busy schedule to come and interact with the students. I just want to say that it had been a really enlightening session and must have filled all our students with great enthusiasm, especially those who have the talent to actually write the things and maybe take it forward to write their own books. So, and definitely this literary club will in future organize more workshops for the students so that they can actually enhance these skills and be one of the good writers, and may their books come in the bestsellers. So I thank you for this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. With all that being said and done, I'd like to thank our Dean, Ms. Dr. Lochan Jolly ma'am, for her presence, encouraging words, and the time she put in for us. To correct us, show us the right path, to guide us throughout, I'd like to thank our faculties in charge, Commander Vijay Pratap Singh sir, Mrs. Seema Nagrani, Mrs. Vasudha Jhunjhunwala ma'am, and Mrs. Mamta Pandya ma'am. And our gems for today are amazing speakers. We'd like to thank each one of you for your presence, time, and also for sharing your amazing experiences with us. And how can we forget our team of writers and editors for the magazine? On behalf of the whole committee, we thank you all for your constant hard work, dedication, and contribution in our magazine. And lastly, we'd like to thank each and every one of you guys for your presence and patient listening throughout the event. We hope that you like today's event, and we expect maximum participation in the upcoming literary club. Also, don't forget to check out our magazine on our website. Once again, thank you everyone. Have a great day ahead. And please fill the feedback form, which is pasted in the chat box.